Well, I'm expecting twin granddaughters to be born in this coming week. And so I thought I'd make a second story here for the following Friday, another escapade as a boy. You know, I had a bad habit of telling tall tales, and there's a price to pay when you do that. It's like the little boy who cried wolf too many times, and when the wolf actually came, nobody paid him any heed. The scripture says that he who walks with integrity walks securely, but he who perverts his ways will become known. And the idea here is this, that the upright man is always safe. The person who tells the truth is always safe. He doesn't have two characters that he's playing, and he has to remember which role he's playing at any given time. A person who's walking honestly doesn't need a good memory. He just tells the truth as it is. But here we have a man who perverts his ways. The idea is he knots it, he twists it. And when you twist it, the problem is that you get found out, because the real you is sooner or later going to come to the fore. So it's important that we become people who are honest, that we say what we mean and mean what we say. When I was a boy, that wasn't the case. I was always telling these tall tales. Well, that backfired on me because my mother started getting phone calls from the school. I was not showing up on time, and she couldn't understand that because I was being sent off to school at a good time. It was quite a long walk, but I should have had more than enough time to get there. So she asked me about that, and I said, well, sometimes I get so tired that I have to crawl on my hands and knees to school. And she discounted that. What a silly story that was, that I would have to crawl on my hands and knees to school. Until one day she came out of the kitchen into the hallway and she saw me crawling on my hands and knees. And she said, what are you doing? I said, well, I'm going to the bathroom. Well, why are you on your hands and knees? I said, well, I don't have any strength to walk. And suddenly she realized that there was something seriously wrong. At first they thought it was rheumatic fever. It turned out it was mononucleosis. I was out of school for 2 months and really took a whole year before I recovered. But this is the problem, you see, that when you don't tell the truth, people suspect you in everything you say. But when, as the scripture says here, you walk uprightly or you walk with integrity, then you walk securely. People know where you're going. They can anticipate that what you say is what you mean, and they can take you at your word. How valuable that is in life, for people to take you seriously. When you say things, they understand exactly what you mean. The sad story of Lot, that when he warned his sons-in-law about the coming judgment, they thought he was joking. He must have had a long history of that, and they just expected this was another joke. So it's good to be happy. It's good to enjoy good stories. It's not good to be dishonest and to say things that aren't the truth, because in the end, when we twist our own ways, we get found out. In the end, we will be found out. And then the duplicity will play against us, and it will be to our own disadvantage. So telling the truth is the best way to go. Say what you mean what you say, and let people have trust when you open your mouth and what you're saying is really true.